This is animation example gives us. When we get bored with small display, maybe we should try a larger one. One of the larger displays that is easy to use is an LED matrix. And this is 8x22 LED matrix we will try to use with an Arduino. This is a brand new LED matrix, so I will start with the unboxing. This module actually is 4 8x8 LED matrix cascaded to one module. We got 5 pins here, VCC, ground, they are for power, and then DIN, CS, CLK, they are for data communication. With this pin, we know that this LED matrix communicates with a microcontroller like Arduino or so with SPI connection. I will use an Arduino Uno to control this LED matrix. Or maybe I will just use Arduino Nano to make it smaller. So here's the wiring diagram, and let's start the wiring. Once the wiring is done and you are confident with that, move to Arduino IDE. We need MD parallel library. You should install it first. If you don't have one, then download it first. You can download from library manager, search for MD parallel. Once the library installation is done, then we can open the sample file from the library. We can start with parallel scrolling. First, you need to edit the hardware type, change to FC16_SW. And since we only use 8x32 LED matrix or 4 MAX modules cascade, we should change the MAX devices to 4. You don't need to change the pins if you are using wiring diagram from this tutorial. I will try to print text, consider subscribing milliohm. So I added the new message variable. Upload the code and it's done. Wait, before we continue the video, you can make me really happy by subscribing to this channel and tap the bell so you won't miss new video from me. You can try to change the scrolling speed here. Less value means more speed. And you can try to change the scroll pause delay here. I try to decrease the pause delay, and here's what I got. By the way, this sample sketch also able to print the text from serial monitor. So let's try it. I type, "Hey, what's up?" Make sure that you choose the new line here and match the baud rate. Then press enter. And this is what I got. We have success print tag. Now let's try to print some sensor data to LED matrix. Like usual, I like to use DST11 as a sample sensor because it is simple, easy to use and has two data output. Let's add a DST11 sensor to our circuit. Here's the diagram. And this is the sketch to display the temperature and humidity data from sensor to LED matrix. I modify the example sketch and here's the little explanation. Of course, we need DST library. Then we define the DST pin. The sensor is connected to pin 2 of Arduino. And these are the variable for data. And we jump to setup. We have dst.begin here. And in loop, I call function named sensorThings. The function will read the humidity and temperature data from sensor and print to serial monitor. After sensor is read, we convert the data from float to char. To convert float to char, we need to convert that to string first. Then convert the string to char. After we have the char data, then copy the data to cureMessage variable. cureMessage is the variable that will print to LED matrix. So whenever you want to print a data, move the data to cureMessage variable. Then I call the function displayHandle to refresh the display with new data. Now, how if we want to add more LED matrix so it will longer and can load more text? How do we do that? Easy. Just buy more matrix and connect every pin to another LED matrix. So, for example, I will add 2 more LED matrix modules. So, I have 3 in total. I connect all pins from the first module to second and second to third, and so on. Now, in the sketch, you should edit the matrix to 12, because one module is 4, then 3 modules mean 12. And upload the code. Now you should see the three matrices are running properly. I will try one more example from the library. That is animation catalog. And I won't edit the tag, upload the sketch and... This is animation example gives us. So I think this is the end of this video tutorial. In the next video, maybe we can make project using this LED matrix display. Do you have any idea or suggestion on what project we can make using this matrix LED? Let me know by leaving your comment below. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on the notification and share this video to your friends so it will encourage me more to make another video. Thank you.